Hello, 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 my queenies. Welcome back to my channel. If you're new, hit the like and subscribe button. It's your girl, Kanisha Nicole with Kurrency Kween Budgeting. On this video, we will be setting up my Happy Planner budget binder. It is an undated planner. If that is something that you are interested in, stay tuned. Okay, guys, I actually forgot I had this planner. I picked it up and I'm not sure what I picked it up because I like the design on it. Know your worth. It is a Happy Planner, the classic planner, the classic edition. And we will go through this and then we will get started. And as you guys know, Happy Planner always have a budget layout. This planner does come with the tab stickers, in which I will not be using these because I have some other ones that I want to try. But if I can't try those, then we will use these. But if I can't make those work, we will use these. And here's the cover page. I actually started in this book and I decided that I wanted to jump on here, so I stopped, and we're going to get started from here. This sticker here says the plan. I also wrote a quote here: the more your money work for you, the less you will have to work for money. For my financial goals area, I just put no excuses, save $1,000. So I plan to save an extra $1,000 outside of my savings challenges and my sinking fund. I'm not sure how I'm actually going to incorporate that just yet, but that's what I plan on doing for this month. And for important dates, I have 420. 420 is my son BJ birthday. He will be 23 this year. And this area is where I normally doodle and write down some, you know, I just write down whatever comes to mind there, or just sticker it up. Here is unexpected spends. You keep track of events and unexpected expenses that pop up during the month. So if anything just come up outside what I have budgeted for, just say car maintenance, if I need to get new tires or something, I would write it here. I wasn't expecting to get a new tire, but if I had a blowout or something, I would have to buy that tire, which was unexpected. So I would actually jot that down here. I actually switched this tab out. I wanted to start with this tab for the beginning of this binder. It says, do you want it or do you need it? That is so important when you are budgeting. We want a lot of things, but you know, when you budget, especially when you're on a strict budget, it seems like you need everything in the world. So I wanted to put that on there, just a note for me, which I switched that out. And here is the layout. It starts with the Sunday layout. It, like I said, is undated. We will decorate this just a little. We won't go to the extreme on this planner here because I only use this just for budgeting purposes only. Here I have my expenses sheet. We have a section for your income, then your total income, then for each category has a section for you to write. You have your savings tracker, in which I may use this for my savings challenges, whatever I'm saving for this month. Accounts and debts, I will probably put my credit cards, or I will probably put my credit cards here. And maybe start my student loan, because I actually need to start putting back for that every paycheck. I actually pay that, you know, cashless, but I think I want to start stuffing it as well. And then I really like this about this binder. Every month it gives you a challenge yourself. Monthly budget challenge. For this one, it would be a no spend. I already put my no spend sticker here for a week. And it just says, try not to spend money on anything outside of necessities for at least 1 week during this month. My good week is always the first week of the month. I'm not sure why, but I always can go that whole week without spending anything outside of what I need. My sticker here, I would just come back and report back on the days that I didn't spend. I would just go in and check this off. And it does start with the Monday start. Here is your weekly expenses. Anything that you spend, you will write down here. I keep up with my receipts and my personal planner. I have another one of these that is dated, and I keep my receipts in a small folder, in which I can grab that for you guys real quick so you guys can see, actually see what folder I'm talking about. So this is my personal planner. I actually bought a separate packet to go in this planner here, and I just actually, when I get my receipts, I will place them here and we will jot them down on the weekly expense log. And when I get those receipts, I sit down on maybe Saturdays and I will fill this out. It has your date, your expense or your description, the amount that you spent, if you need or if you want it. And then you also write the week of here. Down here says, where do I deserve a gold star? And then, is there anything I can do better next week? And then it starts over, you know, for the rest of the week. So we're gonna flip back here and we are going to get started on these pages, in which I am going to take these out. You have watched my previous video with my planners. You guys know I like to turn everything upside down, sideways, and any which way it could go to get it decorated how I need it. Okay, for the month of April, let's start with the tab. I have this booklet. It's Agenda 52. By the paper studio. I picked it up from Hobby Lobby. And I will go through and I'm going to find my month from here. I think I'm going to go with this gold here. And we're going to start with April. Put this on this side first. Let me grab my tweezers. And I'll grab this April here. Can I see that? I think it'll work. We're gonna make it work. I'm gonna set this to the side. And I will grab my little washi tape box here. And I think I want to do, let's do the bunny like we did the other planner. This will be something simple. We're not going to go all out for this planner because I really only pull it out just to look at what bills need to be paid and when. And as with this planner, it will be for the purpose of doing these videos. You guys know when I get to doing things, I kind of tend to get quiet. So I am going to decorate and I am going to fast forward and I will be right back. To this, I will also go back into my agenda 52 and let's find some cute little dates, which we might go with gold since we have the gold accent here, and I think these would be perfect. Do I want to go with the whites or the gold or the black? No, we're not gonna do black. Let's see, I think I have some pastel colors. Let's go with purple. Y'all can see I use this a lot. Let's go with pink. So you guys know I am going to get this started. And then I will fast forward it. And I will be right back.
I wake up every minute with a fever dreams. I push a mind to a limit where it needs to feed. I work blind, got vision I don't need to see. I'm picking mind over matter, I believe in me. I need to find more hours in the day to breathe. Need to find more power in the way I be. And when my mind turns out with the painful scenes, I need to scream out loud, I can't stop me. I wanna be the greatest like Rocky. You know I leave them all hating like a hobby. I'm out here making moves like a lobby. And if you ain't with me, it's your loss, see. I got my mind on the facts, I'm a python. Grab what I like real fast, choke until I have everything I attack, everything that I lack, everything that I want. And I see, matter of fact, cause I'm my own worst enemy. Only if I let it be, I can control anything if I can just think carefully. I control my destiny. Deep up in my mind, I manifest it. Every morning I wake up, I'm so
have the stickers on for the day. We are going to move into adding our bills to our layout. I think this is cute with the pink. I like that. So for the bills, we will be using Happy Planner stickers, Me and My Big Idea books. This first one is Spend Now, Save Now, Spend Later. We will use some out of there. We may use some out of Happy Plans. I'm not sure. We'll see how that go. And also, I have the budget sticker book from Happy Planner. So, for the first, we all know what's due on the first. And that is our house payment. As you guys can tell, I love my little tweezers here to place my stickers so I can make sure they are straight. If I didn't have on my nails, I probably would not be using this. But it makes everything easier with this. And then we have nothing on the second that is due. The third, or the, we have something on the fourth, which is a credit card, which I will pull off a red credit card, stick it here, and you can place your stickers, your icon stickers, anywhere you would like them. I prefer down here because sometimes I will write up here. I like to have this extra area to write in. Or maybe if I want to put a sticker here, I will use that. For the fifth, we have nothing. Sixth, the seventh, we have a subscription, which I think is Roku or Netflix. I'm not sure which one. Off the top of my head, which is due. The eighth, we have payday, and we also have a credit card due that day. And we are going to get a different credit card out of this binder here, just so I can be colorful. Oh no, I love my colors. And we also have a payday for here, which I think I'm going to pull out of this book as well, because it'll, I think I have some that matches the pastel colors. Let's see. Be able to find them when I actually jump on this camera, but it's okay. You know why? Because I think they are in here, the ones I am looking for. I would never find them in there because they are right here. Cute payday. We're just gonna put our payday up here up top. And since we are in this, we're also going to add our other payday, which will be the 22nd. I wish this is a piggy bank. He's so cute. Okay, we don't have anything on the 9th. The 10th, we have our light bill, which is our utilities for the 10th. Here in Conway, here in Conway, we have all of our bills on 1. So when I say my utilities, that means all of our household bills, my light bill. Have my internet, my water, my trash bill, all on 1. You also can have your cable bill on there. You're in a landline. I think they offer a landline still. And you can all have all that on 1 bill. And you can pay that 1 bill for all of everything. And that is so convenient for us here. And we also have CenterPoint as well. We have gas for our water heater. So that is all of that. We have nothing on 11 or the 12th. The 13th, we have another subscription that is due. Throwing stuff everywhere. Nothing for the 14th, the 15th, or the 16th. The 17th, I don't have anything on the 17th. But I will add, let me grab my stickers. I did have some stickers that I was using in my other planner, but I will make more. I don't want to add these. So I will know. So this is Good Friday here. And then we have Easter on the 17th. We have nothing due on the 18th or the 19th, the 20th. We don't have anything. The 21st, we have our car. Notes, but actually I think I want to add in tax day, which is the 18th. Gotta make sure we have our taxes paid. Okay, and that's kind of close, I think. Yeah, I pulled it off wrong. The 21st, we have our car note, in which that is that's cashless, so we don't stuff for that, but we do use our purple car here. Which I'm going to stick that right here for right now because I want to put my auto pay down. Let's go with a coral color. I probably should want purple. Let's do purple since we already got pink there. Do that. A purple on purple. See how that look. And I always use this particular card for my card note. put a full card. That way I know it's for a card note. And then I have here is payday. And on the 22nd, we have, I want to say our Amazon is due on that day. Let's see what we have in here. And happy plans. Let's see what sticker we can pull out. We might not find anything here, but we will look. No. So let's go in here and find something. Let's go with this one. It's a bit dramatic, but I think it's cute. Build it. And that will be, I want to say our Amazon bill. If I haven't already said that. Nothing's due on the 23rd. The 24th will be J-Man's cell phone bill. And then on the 28th, will be my cell phone bill and my cell phone bill, me and Kanaya's. And also on the 28th, we have a subscription. I'm just gonna go ahead and get these out the way while I have this page open. On the 28th, yeah, it is due on the 28th. One we just picked up. I just picked up a Philo and we like it, so we will be using that as well. I have to start cash stuffing for that. And then we're going to go backwards into the 26th because that is for my insurance. And like I said, I use a, I want to get an automatic payment out of here. Automatic payment for my insurance. And we do this facing car. And I also put that right there on top. And I think I have one more, which is my gas bill, which I was telling you guys about center point. And that is due on the 29th. For this notes section, what I am going to do, I think I'm just going to put a couple of quotes here. What's going on the whiteout? Let's see. Make sure it's working right. Okay. What I'm doing, I will write white this out. see if we can find something up here. It's really cute. Pastels. This is the goals binder. This is the goals sticker book. I like this focus on your goals or the good things are going to happen. Let's find something else. Oh, I wish that was colorful. Maybe not. Let's go with a take action orange. I'm gonna put this here. And we are going to grab a couple of quotes out of here. Nothing too fancy. If you're saving, you're succeeding. I like that one, but it's like the wrong color for what I'm doing here. Let's go with your future looks so bright. I think I want to put that one down here somewhere. Let's do this one. Your speed doesn't matter. Forward is forward. And that is a great quote for budgeting, because I know we all want to jump into this and go head first, but you know, as long as you save a dollar, if you can get on here and save a dollar, that'll be more than what you saved last year. So anything is worth doing. If you can just only put back 50 cents a paycheck, that is more than what you save last paycheck. And I think I will leave this part open for a written quote. I'm not sure what I want to write yet. Yes, I do. I know exactly what I want to write. Let's see what color we want to go with. A blue. Let's go with this color blue. So I want to write, becoming rich is hard. Staying broke is hard. choose your heart. And I'm just going to bubble this in because I love this. Guys, I am not one of those fancy planner designers or whatever you call them that do those pretty spreads. I actually just started actually designing my planners with stickers back in, I want to say November of last year. So I am still kind of new to this. So we are getting the hang of this. I can't do all that good doodling and stuff, but I think we will get there one day. I forgot to add in when I have to pay my tides. Let me actually put that in. At the end of the month, because we save up all month, we budget for that all month. I'm still missing something on here. I'm not sure what it is. Oh, I do know what it is. I want to add on the day where I transfer my money to my savings account as far as bill exchange. So bill exchange will go right here. At the end of the month, we do bill exchange. Next, we will do our expenses here. I think I want to go, I need a pretty color. I should just go with this color because I really like this. Pink. It's like a coral color almost. It's pink, but it's real cute. I will write my income in here once I get the paychecks. On what I'll do that, but I will go ahead and pre-fill this one with you. We'll place our month here, and I think I want to just print a sticker. I'm not going to write that there. And for housing, we're going to pay our house payment. Okay, we got our house note. For utilities, we have our Conway Corp. And that normally runs me about $250-ish. And then we have center point. I wish that probably run me about $125 right now. For transportation, I have my car note. Then I have my insurance, which that is for two cars, life insurance, and my insurance for my house. Then we have gas. in which we will budget for maybe $150 a month. Then I have Conway Regional. Which is a medical bill, which I pay $30 a month for that. And we are getting that knocked all down. We're almost finished with that. I'm excited for that. And all of these are cashless, except for gas. I actually stuff for gas. I may start stuffing for my insurance, car notes, my utilities. I think I'm going to start stuffing that. Just a little at a time, not the full payment. I'm just going to stuff that way I can get to almost a month ahead. So that I'm going to start doing that. And for food, we're going to do groceries. And which you guys know is just me and my daughter. So we will go, let's do maybe $250-ish. Let's do $260. Sometimes I will budget exactly for this, or I will go lower. Or if I feel the need, if we're going to, you know, have some company or something for that month, we'll go higher. Because I do have my nieces and nephews that like to come stay over, mostly my nephew. Okay, then we have eating out. This is something we never budget for. But it is something that I plan on budgeting for this month. But we'll see how they go. I'm just going to budget $40 for now. Personal, we're going to do card 2. And card 2 is $42. Card 3 is $25. In which I paid off card 1 earlier this year while I was budgeting. I paid that off already. And then we have our phone bills. And we have 3 phone lines for me, my son, and my daughter. And I don't remember exactly the amount for that on the phone bills. It actually comes out of the account. I don't stuff for that either. For entertainment, we have Netflix. Netflix runs us about $20. For Roku, which I think I'm going to get rid of Roku. Not sure yet. That runs us $11. Then I have Amazon Prime. Which is $15. But this now comes out of my business account. So I may not be stuffing for this anymore. It actually comes out of my business account. And we picked up Philo. In which we actually love it. That is $26. For my Tides. We will budget $300. And then we will do, at the end of the month, we will tally up our income, our expenses, and what we had remaining. We'll go here. And as I mentioned earlier, our savings will go here. Whatever we do for our savings challenges, I think I'm just going to write that here. Debts would be maybe my credit cards, whatever I pay off. I'm not sure how I will actually use this one yet, but we will use that. And then once I get my receipts for this week, we will use this and we will write the date here. And I think we will start that date with the 3rd through the 9th, will go here. And then, like I said, it has one for every week. For here, I want to jot down a few things. It says take notes here, in which I think I'm going to go with the purple. And you all know why I go with purple. So I'm going to grab this book here, which is Happy Quotes from, of course, Happy Planners. And I am going to go with a write it on your heart. Okay. What I want to write on my heart for this month, and probably I will probably do this for every month, because I think this is going to be important to me. Number one, count my blessings. Number two, practice kindness. Number three, let go of what I can't control. Four, listen to my heart. Five, be productive. Yet calm. Six, let's put just breathe. And then, go back with my pink. And let's just do a little doodle. I'm gonna be relentless. For the month of April 2022. I think I want to write a to-do up here. Yeah, let's write to-do there. This is a dotted grid. I probably will decorate that. I'm not sure what I'll do with this month. And then we'll start that month over back in May. I think this will be all for this planner until next month. But we will see. If I come up with something, or if I feel like decorating my back page here out of boredom or something, I will jump on here and let you guys see that. But that is how I get ready for my month. That is how I actually do most of my breakdowns and what I'm going to do. What I'm going to save for, actually. But, guys, it was fun doing this with you guys. I was so nervous doing this because this is my first time actually letting somebody just watch me do this. This is actually my therapy. that I do when I get overwhelmed, I open up a planner, I decorate. I actually start doing spreads or whatnot. And I think I want to get on here and actually do a spread with you guys and let y'all tell me what you guys think. Be sure to drop in your comments what you think of how we decorated this. What does it look like to you? Do I need to add more? Take off more? Is it just perfect? What do you guys think? Leave me a comment below. And as you guys always know, be blessed, Kweenies. Thank you.